हेलो स्टूडेंट, सो लेट्स सी अबाउट द सैक्रम. सो सैक्रम इट इज़ द थिक फ्लैट ट्रेंगुलर बोन विच इज़ प्रेजेंट इन टू द पोस्टीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द बोनी पेल्विस. सो सैक्रम इट इज़ फॉर्म बाय द फ्यूजन ऑफ फाइव सैक्रल वर्टिब्रा, मीन्स S1, S2, S3, S4 एंड S5. दे आर फ्यूज ज्वाइन टू फॉर्मिंग दैट द सिंगल बोन. देन द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द सैक्रम, दैट इज इट शुड बी ट्रांसमिट द बॉडी वेट into that the lower limb throughout the sacroiliac joint. So let's see detail about the sacrum. Here you can see that is the sacrum, this one. This is the anterior side, or that is called the pelvic surface. This is the dorsal side. So sacrum, it is the large flattened triangular wedge shaped bone which is formed by the fusion of five sacral vertebra. So here you can see this is the first, second, third, fourth and the fifth. These five sacral vertebra, they should be fused with each other to forming that the single bone, that is called the sacrum. And this sacrum, it articulates either side by, that is the ilium of here on this side and this side, ilium of the hip bone, to form the sacroiliac joint. And on the upper side here, it is joins with the fifth lumbar vertebra to form, that is the lumbosacral joint. And on the lower side here, it is joins with the coccyx vertebra, this joint here you can see, to form, that is the sacrococcygeal joint. Then the functions of the sacrum, that is, are first function, that is, it forms the posterior part of the bony pelvis. Then it also supports the vertebral column, and it also transmit the weight of the body to the pelvic girdle throughout the sacroiliac joint. So here, so this is the sacrum. So let's see about the detail of the feature of the sacrum. So this sacrum, it is formed by the posterior part of the bony pelvis. It also supports the vertebral column, and it transmit the weight of the body to the pelvic girdle throughout that the sacroiliac joint, which is present on the both lateral side of the sacrum. Then the keeping the anatomical position of the sacrum. So here, that is the smooth pelvic surface, this one, it faces downwards and the forwards. So here you can see. And its rough dorsal surface, this one, here you can see, it should be faces upwards and the backward. Then that is the upper surface. So here you can see, that is the upper surface of the body of first sacral vertebra is directed, slips forwards an angle about the 30 degree. Then the upper end of the sacral canal, so here you can see, that is the sacral canal, this one. This is the sacral canal. So the upper end of the sacral canal, it is directed almost upwards and slightly backwards. So this one. Let's see the external feature of the sacrum. So sacrum, it represents the following features. That is, first, it is the base. Here you can see this upper part, this is the base. Then that is the lowermost part, this is the apex, this one, this line. Then it consists of the four surfaces. So four surfaces that consist of here, that is the, this one, this is called the pelvic surface. Then this posterior part, it is called the dorsal surface. Here you can see this one rough surface, that is the dorsal surface. And here on both lateral side, you can see this one, this is the lateral surface. Then let's see, that is the base of the sacrum. So base of the sacrum, it is directed upwards and forward. So here you can see, it should be directed upwards and forward. And it is formed by the superior surface of the first sacral vertebra here, and it is divided into the three part. So this is the base, and it is divided into the three part. The medial part, this one, it is formed by the oval upper surface of the body of the first sacral vertebra, this one, here you can see.
एंड एंटीरियर बॉर्डर इट इज टर्म एज द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी. दिस वन दिस एंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी इट इज कॉल्ड द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी. द राइट एंड द लेफ्ट लेटरल पार्ट. सो हेयर यू कैन सी दिस इज द राइट पार्ट एंड दिस इज द लेफ्ट पार्ट. दे आर फैन शेप एंड इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द अपर सरफेस ऑफ द लेटरल मासेस ऑफ द सैक्रम. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द आला ऑफ सैक्रम. दिस पार्ट हेयर यू कैन सी दैट इज द वेंट्रल पार्ट. देन द लेटरल मासेस हेयर यू कैन सी दिस वन दैट इज द लेटरल मासेस इट रिप्रेजेंट डिफ्यूज costal elements and the transverse element of the sacral vertebra. Then that is the body. So here you can see that is the body of the first sacral vertebra. It articulates with the fifth lumbar vertebra to form the lumbosacral joint, and the joint it is on the upper surface of the first sacral vertebra that should be occurs. Then here you can see that is the vertebral foramen. So this one. So here you can see this is the vertebral foramen. So the vertebral foramen it present behind that the body, and it is triangular and leads into the sacral canal. So here you can see that is forming that the sacral canal. Then that is the transverse process. So this one. So that is the transverse process. They are massive and fuse with the corresponding transverse costal elements. So this one and this side. ठीक है टू फॉर्मिंग दैट द ब्रॉड स्लोपिंग एरिया विच इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द एंटीरियर साइड दैट इज कॉल्ड द आला ऑफ सैक्रा. देन दैट इज द स्पाइनस प्रोसेस. सो दिस वन. सो द स्पाइनस प्रोसेस फॉर्म द फर्स्ट सैक्रल ट्यूबरकल. सो दिस वन एंड दैट इज द सुपीरियर आर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस. सो दिस वन द सुपीरियर आर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस दे आर वेरी मच prominent and projects that is on the upward side. They flank the superior opening of the sacral canal. This one. Then let's see that is the apex. This one. So apex it is the lower narrow blunt extremity which is formed by the inferior surface of the body of the fifth sacral vertebra. It bears the oval facet which articulates with the coccyx to form that is the sacrococcygeal joint. So here that forming the joint to form the sacrococcygeal joint. Then surface of the sacrum. So as you know sacrum consists of the four surface, that is this is the pelvic, then posteriorly dorsal surface, and that is the two lateral surface. So let's see that is the pelvic surface of the sacrum. So it is concave which is directed downwards and forwards, and it consists of the four transverse ridges. So here you can see this is the first, this is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth. ठीक है. So these four transverse ridges it represents the fusion of the five sacral vertebra. Then lateral to that the four transverse ridges there is presence that the foramina on both lateral side. So that is called the ventral sacral foramina. So here you can see this one, this one, this one, and this one. Then the part of bone lateral to that the foramina it is called the lateral mass. This one. Then let's see the dorsal surface. So here you can see the dorsal surface of the sacrum. So it is very much rough, irregular, and the convex surface. So on the median plane it shows that is the median sacral crest. This one. So median sacral crest it is formed by the forming of the modification of the spinous process of the upper four sacral vertebra, which is modified into that the sacral tubercle. This one, and it forming that the crest that is called the median sacral crest. Then lateral to that the median sacral crest on the posterior surface it is formed by the fused laminae of the upper four sacral vertebra. This one and this one. The lamina of the fifth sacral vertebra. So here that the lamina of the fifth sacral vertebra, they are failed to join behind to forming that the U-shaped gap. It is called the sacral hiatus. This one. Then lateral to that the lamina, there are the four articular tubercle in line with the superior articular process. So here you can see in this. This is the superior articular process and it should be forming that the tubercles here. So it is called the forming that the ridge like structure. So it is called the intermediate sacral crest. Then the inferior articular process of the fifth sacral vertebra, this one, it projects downwards as the forming to that the sacral cornua, this one, that is called the sacral cornua. Then lateral to that the intermediate sacral crest, there is again presence a pair of the four foramina. So here you can see. So that is called the dorsal sacral foramina. Just lateral to it, there is presence again that a crest like structure, this one, on both side. So this crest like structure, it is formed by the fusion of the transverse process of the sacral vertebra. So that is called the lateral crest, this one and this one. The lateral surface. So here you can see. So there are two lateral surfaces are present, the right and the left lateral surface. So each lateral surface, it is the lateral aspect of the lateral mass formed by the fusion of the transverse and that is the costal element of the sacral vertebra. Okay, it is wide above and narrow downwards. So here you can see that is the wide part on the upper side and as it goes downwards, so it forming that the narrow part. Then that is the lower narrow part, it turns medially to form inferolateral angle. So this one. Then the upper wide part, it bears that is the L shape articular surface which is present on the anterior side. So here you can see this one. And it is deeply pitted on that the posterior side. So this articular surface, it articulates with the ilium of the hip bone to form that is the sacroiliac joint. Then the sacral canal. So here you can see that is the triangular canal like structure. So the sacral canal, it is formed by the superimposed vertebral foramina of the sacral vertebra. Here. The upper end of the sacral canal, it is directed upwards in the line with the vertebral canal of the lumbar vertebra and its lower end that should be open into that the sacral hiatus. So here you can see this inverted part called the sacral hiatus. Then the sacral canal, it is communicates with the pelvic and that is the dorsal foramina. So here that is the dorsal foramina and same like this is the pelvic foramina. So they are connected with each other throughout the intervertebral foramen and opens into that the sacral canal. So in this sacral canal you can see. Then the content of the sacral canal. So that is, it consists of the lower part of the cauda equina, then second one that is the phylum terminale, that is the spinal meninges and the lateral sacral vessels. So those structure, they should be passes into that the sacral canal. Then the structure which are emerging throughout the sacral hiatus. So here you can see this is the inverted U-shaped sacral hiatus. So it should be passes the fifth sacral nerve. So from this region, then the coccygeal nerves and that the phylum terminale. So those structure, they should be passing out throughout that the sacral hiatus. Let's see that is the attachment. So first we should have to see that is the attachments related to that the base. So on the upper surface of the body of the first sacral vertebra,
it articulates with the L5 vertebra to form, that is, the lumbosacral joint. Then on the smooth medial part of that, the ala, it is related with, that is, the sympathetic trunk. So here you can see that is related with the sympathetic trunk. Then that is the lumbosacral trunk. So here you can see that is the lumbosacral trunk. Then iliolumbar artery, this one. And last one, that is the obturator nerve. So those are the four structure which is related to that the upper surface of, or the medial part related to that the ala of sacrum. Then rough lateral part of the ala. So here you can see in this diagram, this one, it gives the origin to that the iliacus muscle. So this one here on both lateral side here, that is the origin of iliac muscle, which is present anterior side. And that is the attachment of the lumbosacral ligament here on the posterior side. So in this region. Then that is the apex. So this one. So apex, it bears that the oval facet which articulates with the fifth coccygeal vertebra to form, that is, the sacrococcygeal joint. Then on the pelvic surface, so here you can see this is the pelvic surface, this one. So on the pelvic side, it shows that is the median sacral vessel, this one. Okay. Then second one, that is the sympathetic trunk, they are related to that the pelvic surface on the median margin of the pelvic sacral foramina. So here you can see this one, that is the sympathetic trunk. Then the upper two and half sacral vertebra, that is related with the parietal peritoneum, except that the site of attachment of medial limb of the sigmoid colon. Then the lower two and half vertebra, so here this region, it is related to that the rectum, but it is separated from S3 vertebra bifurcation of the superior rectal artery. Then the piriformis muscle, so here you can see this one, E shape. The piriformis muscle, it is arises from the bodies of middle three sacral vertebra, which is E in shape. Then the pelvic sacral foramina, this one, that is the four pair of pelvic sacral foramina. It transmit, that is, the ventral rami of the corresponding upper four sacral nerves. So here you can see. After then, let's see that is the attachments related to the dorsal surface of the sacrum. So the dorsal surface, it shows that is the four pair of the dorsal sacral foramina. So it passes the dorsal rami of the corresponding upper four sacral spinal nerves. Then the erector spiny muscle. So here you can see this. So the erector spiny muscle, it should be arises from the U-shaped linear area involving, that is, the spinous and that is the transverse tubercle, this one. Then that is the multifidus muscle. So here you can see the multifidus, it arises from the area enclosed by the U-shaped origin of the erector spiny muscle. Then here on the lower side, on the lateral surface, so it should be gives the origin of the gluteus maximus muscle. Apart from this, that is the sacrotuberous ligament, it is attached to this region, sacrospinous ligament and the coccygeus, they should be attached to that the lateral side of the apex of the sacrum. Then on the lateral surface, from this region, there is the attachment of the strong interosseous sacroiliac ligament. So here on this side. So those are the attachments related to that the sacrum. After then, let's see the sex difference between the male and the female sacrum. So that is the male sacrum, it is longer and narrower than the female. Then second difference, that is the width of the body of the first sacral vertebra. It is greater than, that is the ala of the sacrum in the male, and in female, that is the width of the body and the ala of that the sacrum, it is same. That is the third one, that is the concavity on the ventral aspect. So here you can see, that is the concavity which is present on the ventral aspect of the sacrum. It is more uniform and is shallower in males. In females, that the concavity, it is irregular. Then the next is, that is the sacrovertebral angle, this one, or here in this region. That is the sacrovertebral angle, it is more prominent in the female, and the downward direction of the pelvic surface is greater than in the male. The size of pelvic cavity, it is more in the female than the male. So those are the difference which is present in relation with that the sacrum. Let's see the ossification of the sacrum. So sacrum should be regarded as the ossification of the 5 separate sacral vertebra, that is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and the 5th. So there are 21 primary center and the 14 secondary centers. They are present for the formation or the ossification of the sacrum. So the 21 primary center, that include the 5 for the bodies. This is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and the 5th. Then 10 for the arches, this one. And then the remaining 6 for, that is the costal bar, this one. So in this way, that is total 21 primary centers that should be formed. And the 14 are secondary centers. So out of these 10 for the epiphysis of the upper and the lower surface of the body of each sacral vertebra. Then that is 2 for this one, that is the articular surface on the both side, and remaining 2 for the margins below to that the articular surface. So here, this one. So in this way, that is total 14 secondary centers, they should be formed. The primary center, it appears between the 2nd and the 8th week of the fetal life or the intrauterine life, and fuse with each other between the 2nd and the 8th year of the life. And the secondary centers, they are appear at the puberty and fuse by the 25 years. So in this way, that is the ossification that should be occurs.